Welcome, dear student. This is for our third lecture. We have discussed in yesterday lecture regarding 1G, 2G, 3G, 4G and 5G technology, that is first generation, second generation, up to fifth generation, and also we have seen the comparison between this development generation technologies. Now we will discuss today related to this wireless technology. This topic is also important point of view with the examination, the cordless telephone system means the cordless technology. So the basic for this, if you see in front of your diagram, the diagram shows cord plus wire, then cordless plus wireless. Okay, now see the basic principle for this cordless telephone is basically combination telephone and radio transmitter receiver. These things comes in our mind because every communication system have the basic principle. Each things have the transmitter and receiver, and with the combination of this, the overview of the communication system will be made. Cordless phone has two major parts, base and handset. Base, look at this diagram, this block diagram is very important point of view for the examination purpose. Now see, in this diagram there is the base station, then cordless handset, also one block for the PSTN, that is for public switch telephone network. So first see, base is attached to the phone jack through a standard phone wire connection, and the phone system is look just like a normal phone. The base receives the incoming call as an electric signal through the phone lines, then it converts to FM radio signal and then broadcast that signals. Then the handset receives the radio signal from the base, then it converts it to electric signal, and then this will be sent to signal to the speakers, where it will convert sound to heard you. Okay, when you talk, the handset broadcast your voice through a second FM radio signal back to the base. The base receives your voice signal and it converts to an electric signal and sends that signal through the phone. Then base and handset operate on a frequency pair that allow you to talk and listen at the same time. This process is called as duplex frequency. Now if you see in the block diagram, there is show full duplex system. That's why we have discussed definition regarding the duplex system. Base unit of cordless phone is plugged into the telephone jack on your wall. If you open up the base and expose the circuit board, you will see several components that carry out the function of base. Then main important again one part is in this system is phone line interface. Phone line interface receives and sends telephone signals through the phone line radio. Then it amplifies signal to and from phone line interface. User will controls and speaker phone if present, and broadcast receives this radio signals to and from the handset power supply. The low voltage power to the circuit and recharges the battery of the handset. So these important things nowadays mostly working in today's digital cordless telephone system, that things were lagging in analog telephone system. Then again important part is radio components related with cordless telephone system. Radio components receives the signal from the phone line interface and user controls keypad buttons in front of him or her. The radio components convert the signal to radio waves and broadcast them through the antenna. Radio components will send and receives the signals. Then again the important part for this technology is power components. This DC power transformer supplies the low voltage required by electrical components on the circuit board. The power components on the circuit board work with the power to supply electrical current to recharge the battery of the handset. In addition to these components, some bases also have audio amplifiers to drive speakers for speakerphone features, keypad for dialing. Then now in recent technology there is a LCD display for caller ID. Then in recent technology there is LED light emitting diodes for power charging indicator and state memory for answering machine or callback features. These are the some features available in recent digital cordless telephone system. The next, cordless telephone is telephone with a wireless handset that communicate through radio waves with base station, as we have discussed in with the previous block diagram. So this base station is connected with fixed telephone line with a limited range of its base station, which has the handset. See, when the analog telephone system or the cordless telephone system was made in the market first or invented in market firstly, that time it was have the limited range up to 10 meters, 20 meters. Now with the digital, nowadays with a digital cordless telephone system, you can move around 100 meters to 120 meters. But in analog system, there was the some drawbacks with that, but it was, and now in the market there is new inventions with the digital technology. So the again important part with this is the history of cordless technology. You can see in short the history related with this. These are the frequency range with 1.7 megahertz, with 43 megahertz to 50 megahertz, 900 megahertz, 1.9 gigahertz, 2.4 gigahertz, 5.8 gigahertz. This block diagram with the technology analog cordless phone and digital cordless phones. For both the technologies, there is important part is radio components. There is radio components of the handset are like those of the base. They convert electrical signal from the microphone into FM radio signals, and then it broadcast at the same frequency as the receiving of the base unit. The radio components also receive radio signals at the same frequency as the broadcasting from the base. Then it converts them to electrical signals and send them to speakers or to in the form of ringer or buzzer. Now the comparison with analog and digital technology. With this analog and digital technology, these are between analog and digital. From the history, there were very much difference between to till date between analog and digital technology of cordless telephone system. The analog technology is common in cordless telephones, especially in expensive models. Analog signals tend to be more noisy or to interface with respect to sound quality. These are the some drawbacks with analog technology. In addition, analog signals are easily pick up and interrupted by the radio scanners. Then with the invention with the digital technology, like that, there is allow the phone signals to sound clearer. Furthermore, with this technology, the digital signals are more secure. You can see in 1995 with the digital spread spectrum, that is called the DSS, was introduced for the cordless phones in market. Then the DSS spreads the digital information over several frequencies between the receiver and base, thereby making it almost impossible to drop on cordless phone conversations. So in the digital technology, there is a very much less chances for dropping the calls, whereas in analog technology there were very much drawbacks for the communication related, there is a noisy or interference between sound quality and between two communicators. So this was the some drawbacks with the analog phones. So these are the short points related with the analog phones. Then we will discuss now with what are the things inside a cordless telephones with analog as well as in digital cordless telephone systems. Inside a cordless telephones, the phones have been around, but have you look inside of one? No one is see generally inside the cordless telephone system. What are the things inside of the cordless telephone system? But you can see the overview of the cordless telephone system with these points. The cordless phones have been around, but you have look inside ever? No. So let us discuss with this. Parts of this are related with the some circuits, handset circuit board. Then inside of this there is the keypad, again there is a handset circuit board, then keypad. This keypad is also have the circuit boards, again the keypad to base station as well as on the transmitter or your receiver side of the system. So these systems is related with the circuit boards, the speakers, the microphones, the ringer and the battery inside of these. Okay, so these are the important things included inside the cordless telephone system. Also there is with the microphones, buzzers, these points also important inside the cordless telephone system. So these are the some overview points related with analog phones with digital phones. These are the some points related with analog phones. The cordless telephone generation 1 has a number of disadvantages as given in the points. Quality of the receiver speech is not very good. Already we have discussed transmission can be received by a sound broadcast radio receiver. Okay, so the limited range is there, up to 20 meters to 50 meters only. But in digital technology there is increasing a range to move the user up to 100 meters. So this is the digital enhanced cordless telephone communication, that is DECT you can say. These are the applications of DECT. These applications included in DECT where these things were lagging in the analog communication system. So these applications should be considered in point with DECT. Again, these are the applications for DECT. DECT has also been used for fixed wireless access as substitute for copper pairs in countries such as India and South Africa by using directional antennas and sacrificing sacrificing some traffic capacity. Coverage could extend it to over 10 kilometers. The standard is also used in electronic terminals, traffic lights, and remote door openers. So these are the some applications for DECT. Then these are the some features for the DECT technology. So related with multimedia handset to with the base stations, then related these points with Wi-Fi networks, video senders with the Bluetooth technologies. These things should be added in DECT technologies. Again, these are the points with DECT. Talk time should be increased with several hours. Then longer range between the telephone and base stations, extended should be increased, extended battery life. Then after DECT, it is also a cordless telephone system type, that is a personal handphone system. This is first time developed in Japan as a cordless telecommunication system. In mid 1990, there were introduced with IP based technologies. This IPAS network technology have some advantages related with cost, then infrastructure related with users. These points should be considered with the PHS technologies. These are the features and service related with personal handphone systems. So these points should be considered with your personal handphone system. So students, prepare the block diagram with the base stations, including the cordless telephone system. This block diagram is very much important related with the examination point of view. So I recommend you to all prepare properly this block diagram. This block diagram is very much important in exam point of view. So today we have discussed the important point related with cordless technology. So this block diagram and some short points you should note down in your notebook and make one notebook for the notes properly. Thank you.